All right, everyone. Geoff Carter here. And have a guess what? I'm back in the UK. My trip was caught short. And in a minute, I'm going to tell you the real reason I left Bangkok. Because a lot of people will be saying, oh, has he done this? Has he done that? And basically, I've had a month off social media. So this is the first film I'm making now. Since around the 28th of January, I think. And basically, it all started when I filmed in the M-sphere on Sukhumvit. And that was absolutely out of this world. When I went up to the rooftop there on floor 5, and I got to the... I've got to watch this muddy, it's all muddy. They got to floor 5 and it was there, wasn't it? The tribe, the beach club, Sky Beach Club it was called, and it was out of this world. So if you've not seen that video, I'll put it at the end of this one so you can have a look at it, because that shopping mall, if you're in Bangkok, is well worth a visit. Right, so after filming that, I jumped on a Bolt motorbike taxi back to Soi 11-1, and that's where I was staying, in an ice studio with eye check-in. And it was only 1200 baht a night, very small room, TV but no English channels apart from ABC News, which repeated every 30 minutes. Anyway, got back to the room and the air conditioning wasn't working properly. So I said to the woman at reception, can you get somebody to come and have a look at it? Anyway, they messed about with it, couldn't get it going. So the next day, I had to move rooms to a different room where the air conditioning was working. Anyway, next thing you know, I've moved all my stuff. These blokes are going through my window onto the big units outside with like little gas canister pipes, this, that, the other, messing about with my aircon, the one in the other room. And I thought, this is strange. Anyway, I went out and I think I went to stumble in, had a couple of beers there, come back. Anyway, the air conditioning was working. Anyway, I woke up in the middle of the night, and I was going, and I started coughing, and I thought, I hope this ain't the start of that again, same as I had in Nakhlua, like the chest, you know, like the cold across your chest and clacking when you're coughing, and I think a lot of people have had it lately over there. Anyway, I thought, do you know what, let's just fingers crossed and carry on, eh? Anyway, that's only the start of it. Let's go to the ad and the opening intro, and I'll tell you what happened next. You're not going to believe this. Right then. So 2 days later, I am now still lay in bed. I've gone really weak. I've gone lethargic. I've gone dizzy. And now when I'm coughing, my chest is clacking. So I went to get some noodle soup just down the road, which is about, I don't know, 80 yards away. Got a bowl of soup, and on the way back, I had to hold my stomach. I'd strain my stomach muscles, coughing, you know. A lot of you watching this, if you've been to Thailand, you might have had this before, so you can resonate with what I'm saying. I was blurred vision, couldn't think straight, and I'm thinking, I've got to get out there, I've got to do some more filming. But it was red hot. I thought, you know what, go to the pharmacy. So I went to the pharmacy, spoke to the doctor there, and she was a lovely woman, and she said, oh, you need these antibiotics. A lot of people's got it at the moment in Bangkok. Some people call it Bangkok flu. I don't know whether I had that or whether I've got Legionella from the air condition unit. I don't know. All I knew is I didn't feel right and I needed to get back fit again so I could go filming. Anyway, got them and they were a 5-day course, 2 a day, 1,000 milligram, so they were very, very strong. Anyway, they didn't touch the sides, And I'm thinking, what's my next move here? I thought, do you know what? Could be hospital next. I wasn't feeling right, you know, couldn't think properly. And I'm thinking, I've got to change my visa soon, or I've got to fly out the country. I just couldn't comprehend with what I had to do. So it was like a fever as well, you see. So I was thinking, oh, right, what can I do? So I had two options really, didn't I? Either go to the hospital and they could have kept me in, put me on all kinds of drips and things, and then you've got to claim it back on your insurance. And I'm thinking, I'm not right. And it was red hot in Bangkok and smoggy, couldn't breathe. I thought, best thing you can do, lad, is get home. So I thought, right, I'll get onto Emirates Airlines. So I eventually did like a chat thing online, couldn't ring them. So I'm on chat line like that. And he went, I'm sorry, but because you booked through an agent, we can't change your flight. So that's something to think about, that, right? He says changing his hands because my hands are freezing, right? So if you don't book directly with the airline, when you come to move your flight forward or take it further back, they won't do it. So anyway, I got onto my agent in England then, and they said, yeah, we can do it, but it's £307.80 to change your flight seat. I thought, you're having me over here. Anyway, I thought, I've got no other option. It was either go to hospital in Bangkok or fly home and try and get sorted out here, which is what you'd rather do, wouldn't you, really? What I'd rather do, anyway. So after trying to fill the form in and pay the bill with my credit card, I must have filled the form in about 8 times and I filled it in wrong. Just wasn't thinking right. I was really, really poorly. Anyway, I eventually got it. Flight confirmed, etc, etc. And I'm going to take a break right now and just show you this lovely walk what I'm on, and then we'll come back with the latest info. All right, stay with me. This is the River Mersey running through Warrington. There you go. And it's a lovely walk in winter, spring or summer. Right, let's carry on with this story, shall we? Now then, is nobody more gutted than me that I had to take the flight home option because I had it all planned. You won't believe what I had planned filming around Bangkok for you. And it's really disappointed me. Yeah, listen, number one, I was going to go to Chinatown filming. Number two, Khao Sang Road at night, all buzzing. Three, the Chaya Praya River nighttime buffet cruise. I was going to do that. I was going to do the night markets. I was going to do the floating market. I was also going to do the railway market. And then I was going to go along the Klongs on a long tail boat for you. That was just some things what I had lined up. And I thought, right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 7. Yes, 7 more movies. That'd be great. Everybody will love it. And I would lay there in bed and I thought, even if you could, you're not going to be able to fit it all in now before your flight. And honestly, God, it really upset me because I wanted so much to go around Bangkok and see more. And see stuff that I'd not seen before as well. But it is what it is. Let me just turn the camera around here. This is an interesting thing. This is an old suspension bridge over the River Mersey. It's been here for years. I don't know how long it's going to last now, though, because it's all started rusting. But that takes you over to a place called Owley. And that's where we're heading now, because it's Owley and then into the town centre. All right. We'll carry on with the story in a minute. It's just started raining. Oh, God. Yep, the rain's coming down now. And this, when there's a few of you on it, when we was kids, it wouldn't half bounce. Down there's the way. And up there, it goes to Kingsway Bridge. But I'll tell you something, it's UD up time, because my ears are getting wet. Oh, I hope this stops soon. Mind you, we are in England and it is only February. So yeah, just got to carry on, haven't we? Well, it looks like that rain's stopping again and the sun's showing his face. The sun has got his hat on. Hip 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 hooray. Anyway, that's it. That's my story. And that's what really happened to me. Anyway, when I come back, I was still coughing. Oh, God, I was frightened. Honestly, it was really hurting. Anyway, phoned the doctor up, my doctor, and she prescribed me, and I've got it wrote down here because I won't be able to remember it otherwise, doxycycline. And that's an antibiotic. And she only gave me 5 days worth. But I tell you what, within 5 days, it was gone. And I believe somebody told me when I told them, they said to me, you can get that over the counter at the pharmacy in Bangkok or Pattaya, wherever you go in Thailand. So, yeah, I'll put the name of it here now. Are you ready? That's what it's called. Write it down. And if you get this when you get to Thailand, get straight to the pharmacy and get that stuff down you. Because I tell you what, it absolutely worked wonders. Right, so what's on the cards now for Mr. Carter, we all say? Well, today now I'm going into town and I'm going to enjoy myself. I'm going to have a couple of pints of beer and I'm going to go into Betfred. Right, because I'm going to put the Irish lottery on. And the Irish lottery, three numbers, where we live here in town, they give you £751. Yeah, they give you an extra 50 quid, the one in town, if you get three numbers. And that's what I need to do now, don't I? I need to win some money so we can go away again. So basically, I'll be here for the next few weeks at least until I decide what I'm going to do money-wise, flight-wise, holiday-wise. But I've still got that long list there of things I need to do in Bangkok. So that's all sorted. Might do a quick week in Benidorm. And some people have been asking me, I know it's not popular with all of you, but some people love me cooking in my garden. So I might do that. And my series, Cooking with Carter and Friends. I'm lining a few people up to do different foods from around the world. So that'll all be interesting. So I hope that you'd all keep watching. I know I'm not in Thailand, but it wasn't my fault. I was really, really poorly. And it was an hard decision to make to come back. But I had to. Because after all, ladies and gentlemen, health is wealth. And you can't pour from an empty cup. So I had to get myself better again. Been off social media for a full month. I've rested up and I'm 99% better now. And, that was a bad trip, that was. But it's out the way now. Draw a line in the Peter Pan sand. Peter Pan sand. Oh. Anyway, I'm going on now, aren't I? So, that's what it's all about. Leave your comments. Have you had something bad happen to you while you was in Thailand and had to fly home early? Or have you been lucky and got away with it? Are you looking forward to Songkran? Songkran, tell you. I went once, I said never again. Second time I went, what am I doing here? But that's coming up as well. So all great stuff happening in Thailand for you right now. And if you're new to the channel, I've got some cracking stuff. And look at some of my stuff for a film from other countries. Thailand, Spain, Portugal. It's all good stuff. All right. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the little bell because we love it when you do that, don't we? And I'm going to give you one of them as well. How about that then? You love it when I do that. And it's Geoff Carter, back on YouTube, back on my Facebook, back on my Instagram, back on Twitter, X. So all good stuff. So I'll see you all soon. And what I'm going to say right now is, and the main thing is, keep smiling.